Hey guys, I'm Vollen and today I will teach you my method of studying hiragana and katakana in just one day. So when learning hiragana and katakana, the best possible tool is still pen and paper. It's the same for kanji, it's still pen and paper. Write them down multiple times until they're stuck in your head. I use a website called Tanoshii Japanese. It's not sponsored. And that site is just amazing to learn hiragana and katakana on a fast pace. There are multiple tools for learning it, but that's really the go-to solution that I suggest to everybody learning Japanese. So let's go to the laptop and I'll show you my method of learning hiragana and katakana through that site. Let's go. This is the site of Tanoshii Japanese. When you have an account, it makes things easier, but it's not really needed. So when starting, go to lessons. You can learn hiragana, katakana and kanji on the site, but also vocabulary. So the good thing about this site is when you click on lessons, then you see here the hiragana. When you click on, for example, sashi, su, se, so, you see them all here, how they are written. And when you want to practice them for recognizing them, click on add all, and then hiragana you're learning. And when you know them better after some time with the practices that you can do on this site, then you can set them to hiragana you have mastered. So when going to practice day is over here, you can then click on hiragana, katakana, kanji or vocabulary. When pressing hiragana, single game, check the recognition. And I always did like 5 at a time or sometimes 10. And then I went select characters or just click here, hiragana you are learning, hiragana you have mastered. And then you can just select them. Like if you don't have an account, you can do it like this. And you just select the ones that you want to practice. Then you go next, select how many you want to do. I will do 15 for now. So then you will see here the character. You just have to type in Rumaji. And suddenly it got typed because my parents are working at the electricity. Mistake because I want to be too fast. So, and then you can see my today's score. Yeah, I made a mistake. Normally I don't make mistakes, so that's why I have minus 2 today. And the other ones that I have perfect, and yeah, you can see all the ones that you studied. Plus one that you got wrong. And you can play again if you want to over here. Play again. Or just set more characters or other questions. But there are a couple of other things, but that's the main practice that I did on this site. So when you go back to hiragana and practice single game, you can do matching characters, English flashcards, stroke order. Let's just pick the normal ones again. 15, yes. Look, so then you have to choose the stroke order, like what comes first, and this. But the best thing is still to write them down. But this is kanji. And that's how I've learned hiragana and katakana in one day, mainly because of the first practice. I just kept adding more and more and just repeated it every single time, and I did it for the whole day and it was stuck in my head. And a week later I did it again and I still knew all of them. And it helps a lot to study Japanese when you know hiragana. Katakana can be useful because Japan has quite a lot of foreign words. Katakana is mainly used for foreign words, hiragana for normal Japanese. So thank you all for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them down in the description below, and I'll see you all later. Good luck studying Japanese. Bye bye.